12 of this Scottish side played in the last international against the All Blacks in Auckland in June. One new cap in flanker Murray Wallace, new leadership from Gregor Townsend. The Chalmers Armstrong hinge for the 27th time. That pack concede 1.5 stones a man. Experience in the engine room and in the breakaway blend, Ian Smith to hunt and hound. 10 of the Australian side shared in the 21-16 Sydney defeat of the Springboks. Matt Burke, a power-packed intruder, quick hands in the backs, creativity from Pat Howard and David Knox, who partners Sam Payne in an international for the first time. A huge pack includes the one new cap, Andrew Blades, and the skipper, John Eales, who leads for the 9th time. A 39-year-old schoolmaster from Montélimar in France is in charge today, Patrick Thomas, a former flanker who's been a ref for 20 years. His 4th cap assignment following England, Ireland 94 and 95 and South Africa versus New Zealand in Durban in August. And so Craig Chalmers back in the Scottish side after losing his place, and he's going to start the game with the kickoff. Craig Chalmers today playing in his 48th international match and not going to kick that. That's the Wallaby mascot. So a great roar as Craig Chalmers gets the game underway. And right away it was Owen Finnegan who went up to make the catch. John Eales, number 5, goes round, and there is the first rolling match of the day. Warwick Waugh thumping away. Very good tackle by Gary Armstrong, and a penalty right away. The referee hasn't indicated. That's Warwick Waugh, this huge lock forward who made a great burst away, but clearly an offence on the floor. John Eales just checking up with the referee what it is. So good to see the referee making his point about the ball on the floor and people interfering with it. You can just have a look at this.
Well, here we see Warwick Waugh on the charge there, Bill, and a good tackle there from Gary Armstrong. And I think there was one or two Australians playing the Scottish guys nowhere near the ball and quite rightly spotted by the referee.
Rowan Shepherd, who's scored 23 points for Scotland in his 7 internationals, got it high enough, and it's dead straight. What an amazing start for Scotland. 3-0. They've played just over a minute. And of course, such a delight for a goal kicker to get his very first kick straight between the posts. There he was, 69 points he got in New Zealand, the top boy there. Matt Burke with the restart. Damien Cronin went up for it. Damien Cronin has on the jersey that doesn't have a number on it. It may be that the number 4 jersey wouldn't go round him, but I couldn't aver to that. Scotland, of course, at some disadvantage in pure weight. You can see there, I mean, it's well over a stone a man, and the Australians know how to use it. Patrick Thomas insisting that they wait, and because they delayed the formation of the scrummage, the interception, but the Australians hadn't retired the 10 metres quickly enough. Cronin ready to take the quick one. Good drive in there by Ron Erickson. Now Chalmers feeding, and that was the fullback in the line, but the Scots blocking off obstruction in midfield, and it's a penalty this time to Australia. What a hectic start.
Well, a tremendous start there from Scotland, Bill. It's very reassuring to see them taking the game to the Australians at this early stage. Damien Cronin really in the thick of things, but I'm not quite sure why that penalty was given. I didn't see the incident there, but Scotland really just need to make sure that they don't put themselves under pressure by running these quick free kicks. They just have to take their time. It's very good that they're looking to take the quick ones, but they shouldn't feel under pressure to go so quickly as to allow the Australians to take possession.
This is Matt Burke, who's scored 165 points in his 19 internationals so far. That includes 50 goals and 8 tries as well. You can see he's a burly fellow. And, well, in his last 8 internationals, he's done 133, so he's built the bulk of them recently. He's on form. Matt Burke then, he's given it a big wallop, and the Dutch judges looking, and they see it in. And that was a marvellous kick by Matt Burke. Both the kickers off to a tremendous start. It's 3 points all, they've played 4 minutes. Craig Chalmers. It's high, a bit too far perhaps. Great jump by John Eales. Now this here again is where the Australians try to make ground with the maul first of all. As I say, they're a very big, heavy pack, and mauling is very handy for them, but there the Scots have put it on the floor. And Matt Burke does the clearance work. So it will be interesting to see how often this big fella comes into the line. He was practicing his goal kicking yesterday for ages and ages, and also spent ages practicing his restart kicks. That dedicated. 5 minutes gone, 3-3. Kevin McKenzie back in the side for his 11th international. Played for the Caledonian Reds against Harlequins last Saturday. As a test of his fitness, came through it well. Cody Weir's hands, Cronin did the tidying up. And the Scots doing a roll. Well, they've taken a leaf out of the Australian book. Now it's out to Chalmers. Eriksson having a go. The Australians up so quickly. And David Wilson is in a dangerous position there. A loud blast for, yes, going over the ball. Get up onto your feet before you play it, said the referee. And, well, that looks as if somebody may have made a comment. And it's another 10 metres upfield. And, of course, it brings the posts much closer into range. So there's no excuse for making comments, Gavin.
No, you're absolutely right, Bill. I mean, that's the sort of ill-discipline that Scotland can well do without, quite honestly. I mean, first of all, the kick being well inside Australia's half, they've got no chance really, I think, in these conditions and the winter and the cold of kicking that ball. But 10 yards near the post, it gives Matt Burke an excellent chance of adding to his earlier penalty. And, you know, Scotland really have to knuckle down. They can't afford, obviously, to give away these silly penalties.
So Matt Burke there from the Eastwood Club in Sydney. Scored 20 points against Italy recently. John Ill-mannered shouting from the younger element in the crowd. It's another big kick, but this time it's just outside the right-hand post. So one out of two for Matt Burke, it's still 3-3. They've played 7 minutes. Craig Chalmers making sure everybody's behind the ball, not behind the line. Oh, it's nicely hoisted, certainly gave the forward any amount of chance. Sam Payne, the scrum half, out to Tim Horan. He's a live wire. Scotland 10 metres line. And there you can see Australia have it in their half. Sam Payne Burrows. Nicely out to Knox. Knox with lovely fast hands. That was Daniel Herbert coming in and changing the angle of the attack. Going back to the forwards. Payne once again. He knocked it forward. Just a little bit over anxious, Sam Payne there.
Well, here we see the quality of the Australians. Look at the way the ball is transferred and the speed that it's transferred. And it's good backing up there from the inside. Good tackling from the Scottish defence.
A typical Gary Armstrong kick from the scrummage. Hasn't found his touch. Matt Burke with a very good return into Scottish territory. So Gary Armstrong here, what a delight to all Scots to see him back in action in the test against New Zealand. 33rd cap today for Gary Armstrong. He's actually leading the Courage League's Division 2 try scorers with 14. Shows you the form he's been in down there. That's for Newcastle, of course. Lovely jump by Cronin. And the Scots really driving well. Out to Chalmers. Chalmers trying to feed on to Eriksen. Yes, diving in and trying to kill the ball again. David Wilson was up very quickly. Indeed, there is another terrier in defence. Craig Chalmers sliced that one a bit.
Well, here we see Damien Cronin going up for that ball. He had a nice loud grunt as he went up for it, but almost taking him when he was in the air. The rest of the Scottish forwards coming in behind, trying to clear out the Australian bodies and really taking a leaf out of the Australian book with their rolling maul.
McKenzie's throw, great jump by Doddy Weir. So two very good bits of line-out play by the Scots there. And there again, they're driving that line-out ball. Trying to pull people in to stop them. Still Scotland in charge, they'll want quick ball from here. Gary Armstrong digs for it. Well, it's a loud blast, but I think that interfering with the ball on the ground. Kevin McKenzie was right at the bottom of that one. I think it's all about holding on to the ball on the ground instead of getting to the feet first. David Knox with the good left foot there.
Well, once we see that again, we see the Scots boys trying to take this rolling ball. Gary Armstrong looking for the ball there with his feet. But surprisingly, Kevin McKenzie just going in there, being accused of just standing perhaps on one of the Australian bodies, getting penalised.
21-3. Australia have clipped to two, and it was meant for Eels, but it didn't go to him. It was taken, in fact, back by Owen Finnegan. Owen Finnegan, who joined the tour late and was thrown straight into the match in Perth. David Knox is fed out there. A feed on again to David Knox from David Wilson. Payne once again. Lovely little chip kick through there by Horan. Across there goes Rowan Shepherd. And so that was a lovely, delicate kick indeed by Tim Horan, Australia's most capped centre there.
Well, here we see the versatility of Tim Horan. A lovely little chip in there in behind the Scottish defence. Rowan Shepherd covering across well, but when the ball's standing up there 2 yards from your touchline, you don't have an option but to take it out.
Now a great attacking position here for Australia. We've got Warwick Waugh at number two, John Eales at number four, and behind him is Finnegan. John Eales, who has such a huge standing jump. Scots battling away there to try and prevent the maul over. And there's the maul still, and it may be John Eales who drives over. It was a marvel, but in fact it's Warwick Waugh who drove over. No wonder he's delighted. It was a typical Australian forward rolling maul try.
Well, Australia here, they gather the ball in from the line-out, and you just see the intensity, really, of their effort. Everyone talking to each other. The Scots at sixes and sevens, not enough people getting in behind the ball. There's some big men in the Australian pack there, and Warwick Waugh, we see, just diving over the line.
And Matt Burke then with a score of 8-3 for Australia and with 13 minutes played. Matt Burke, who's very like Grant Fox in the amount of practice that he does, realising how vital goal-kicking is even in Australian international matches where, generally speaking, there are more tries scored. Matt Burke, who once scored 21 points against Wales and 20 against New Zealand. Has he pulled it round enough? Yes, it just squeezed in. He may have taken in a sharp intake of breath at the thought of that, but it got in all right. 10-3 it is. And the thing about the Australian mauling is that they change the angle every now and then. You would see that Warwick Waugh came through at a different angle there, through the thin bit, and that's what made the try. Chalmers high and hanging. Scott's forwards really are giving it everything here. Armstrong changes his mind. Armstrong passed through. Support was there from Ian Smith. They're within 15 metres of the Australian line. Armstrong again. Chalmers the feed. Oh, and that high pass just went nowhere.
Well, a tremendous riposte here from Scotland. Look at Gary Armstrong and the space that was open to him, taking full advantage. Despairing Australian defence there. Good to support from Ian Smith. The rest of the forwards in behind him. They lay the ball on the platform back again. Here we see it again from Armstrong out to Chalmers, looking for the pass with Townsend coming round, who just wants to miss it out to Rowan Shepherd. Unfortunately, the ball not going to hand. One gets a feeling, Bill, that if it had been the Australians in that position, they might have made better use of the ball.
Well, handling with the Australians is their bread and butter, and they do it better than most. However, they've been penalised for offside, and Rowan Shepherd puts on 3 points more, his second penalty goal, and it's 10 points to 6, and they've played almost 15 minutes. So there's no doubt whatsoever that the Scots have decided that the best way to treat this game is to take the game to the Australians with vigour and with aggression, and certainly that's what the forwards are doing. Matt Burke again, who holds the Australian record of 39 points in an international. Up there went Cronin. He held on to Eels. A very good ball for the Australians. When that's fucked back inside, it's David Knox sweeping it back inside. They're just outside Scotland's 22. Sam Payne waiting. Here's another look. See the Scots on the offside line. Payne very cleverly switched it. And back there went Gary Parker, who of course made the mark, Gary Armstrong, who made the mark not only on the run but almost in the air, and you can do that with the mark now. However, his kick has gone to David Knox. Knox over halfway, Payne the scrum half. Now the Scots have already seen how quick this little fellow is, but Gary Armstrong in with the tackle. So that's Sam Payne, who scored 2 tries on the tour so far. His 4th international. Richard Harry at the front of the line out. Warwick Waugh rather shoved his way through there. And that was a bit of compression that the referee saw. Warwick Waugh there, who's he's just under 19 stones. Doddy Weir. Smith goes in. He's got his 10 metres line. The switch from Armstrong. Chalmers gets it out. Tony Stanger engulfed. Scotland 22. Armstrong still though. Gregor Townsend with the big one. Hasn't found touch. Burke returns it with the biggest up and under you could imagine. In comes Shepherd. Their fellow's offside, and it's taken very quickly indeed by Rowan Shepherd.
Well, once again, Bill, Scotland just being a wee bit over-anxious. I think they should just settle it down. They've missed a couple of touch kicks, and they're really giving the Australians all sorts of opportunities to attack. Also, when they get the penalty, they should just settle things down, make sure everyone knows what's going, and not give the Australians anything to play with. They just need a wee bit more composure at this stage in the game.
Beautifully out to Burke, I was saying, what a powerful fellow he is, and a super tackle there by Craig Chalmers. But that was a lovely blindside run by the fullback. And it's Payne who's got it once again. The forwards take it forward into the 22. Payne once again to Knox. Howard comes on the inside run. Payne once again. Knox once more. Knox half through. Tried to get it out to Herbert. And just a chance there as Kenny Logan got the ball with a couple of pals with him, but the Scots penalised.
Well, here we see it, David Knox, just a little chink of a thing, and the centre there was held back from Gregor Townes and Daniel Herbert, and well spotted there by the referee, Thomas.
So that bit of obstruction, and it happens a lot, backs tend nowadays, in a way like professional footballers, if a player gets past them, they try to make sure that he can't do any damage, and there was a bit of shirt tugging there, and the Scottish captain was the man who was penalised. The fifth member of the Gala Club, plays for Northampton now of course, but the fifth member of the Gala Club to captain Scotland, Arthur Dower, Peter Brown, Peter Dodds as well, and of course Jim Aitken, the Grand Slam captain. So Matt Burke won't have a much easier kick on the rest of the tour than this one, hardly any breeze. Again, a lot of youngsters bawling their heads off in an unmannerly way, but it doesn't put Matt Burke off. That's his third successful kick, and it's 13 points to 6, and they've played 20 minutes. So they're dead on halfway. They've played 23 minutes. It's 13-6 for Australia, who have actually won the last five matches against Scotland. Eric Peters with the pickup, but didn't get the ball away. David Wilson doing very well to get a hand in there. Well, the Scots forwards certainly sprightly enough at the moment, Gavin, but it's the cumulative effect, isn't it, of playing against much heavier opponents.
That's right, and obviously the defence of the Australians, Bill, is a real hallmark of their play, and it has been for a good number of years now, and Scotland really need to get a wee bit quicker possession. It's just getting stuck there in either the back of the lineouts or rucks and mauls, and here we see with some better possession what they can do.
Shepherd in the line from Chalmers. Real thumping tackle from Pat Howard on Rowan Shepherd there. Typical Australian tackle, stops the man dead in the tracks. Well, there's Pat Howard, whose dad Jake is down below with the Australian management. He's one of the coaches of the forwards, played seven times for Australia. So father's watching. Manu was in the line there, getting it from Knox. He generated some real pace there. Payne once again. More driving. This is great stuff. The Australians beginning to put it together. Lovely pickup by Knox. As Payne just couldn't quite hold it. Scots have infringed on the ground again. Get to your feet, says the referee. And it's another penalty in an easy spot. Finnegan was the man who led that drive. Last man up. And Andrew Blades was with him as well.
Well, Australia really having a good bit of the play now, and from reverse angle here, David Knox just taking the ball in, feeding it there to Owen Finnegan, and the Scots really at sixes and sevens. Doddy Weir, you can see, just trying to wrestle back the possession. Unfortunately, the referee awarding a penalty to Australia.
Now, Matt Burke here, of course, knows this Murrayfield pitch, because although he hasn't played in an international here before, he did play for the New South Wales Waratahs against the Scottish development side about a year ago, and he scored 17 points in that match, and he's going here to chalk up 11 so far in this one. Burke then flags up again. He really is on form. All that practice is proving worthwhile. 16 points to 6, 25 minutes gone. Three penalties and a conversion for the big fullback. Great Chalmers. Again, John Eales, well protected. I hear the referee shouting, leave the ball, leave the ball. Trying to make sure that the hands are off it. Payne, Knox. Wee bit slicey, that one. So David Knox here, the schoolmaster from Sydney, who plays for the great Randwick club. David Campese's club as well. It was first cap against France way back in 85. He's 33 now. But the Australians regard him as having soft hands, so that he adjusts the weight of the pass so brilliantly. Kevin McKenzie. Doddy Weir with the flip down. Hilton with the clean-up. Armstrong, Chalmers, Townsend. Oh, marvellous run by Tony Stanger. Stanger over the 22. Lovely pass out there to Logan. But what a thumping tackle that was. And the Australians have one vital ball and they're counter-attacking. Knox with a big, big kick. Back goes Townsend. Townsend still has men with him. There's the change of pace. Lovely run by him, almost up to halfway, but the loose ball again, proving so much of a disadvantage to the Scots. Just that last link-up was so important.
Well, what a magnificent move here. Lovely hands from Gregor Townsend. Tony Stanger straight through. He was really looking for support, and unfortunately the Scottish support just couldn't get close enough. A high pass out there to Kenny Logan, well tackled by Jeff Roth. A tremendous smothering tackle there.
Joe Roth putting a tackle there was so crucial on Kenny Logan. And so they're back on the Scottish 10 metres line. Driving too early. And a quick one taken by Armstrong. Ian Smith, the little hound dog there. David Hilton thumps on a bit into Australian territory. Armstrong once again. And a penalty against the Australians. Again, far too many infringements on the ground. The referee trying to ensure quick delivery from the drop phase. Owen Finnegan then.
Well, here we see Gary Armstrong breaking blind and just trying to get the ball. It's interesting, Bill, that the Australians are really not committing themselves to these rucks or mauls. There's only two or three of them going in. The rest of them are standing off and just waiting for things to develop from there. Whereas conversely, Scotland are committing a lot of their players to winning back the ball.
But still 10 points in arrears as Rowan Shepherd. A great record for the Northern Midlands, this lad. He's played 29 games for them and scored 133 points. His dad, of course, Gordon, played for the Northern Midlands as well. This is over 40 metres. Kept it low, but pulled slightly to the left. Really didn't hit that one well at all. It stays at 16-6 and they've about 11 minutes to go to the break. But Howard ready to take a quick one. David Knox as well. But they give it back to the fullback, Matt Burke. That's a little bit of a change. And up very quickly came Finnegan. Murray Wallace feeds it back. Armstrong, Chalmers, missed out Ericsson. And Gregor Townsend furious with himself because he was on the burst there. One of the great concerns, of course, is taking it like this and knocking it forward and then counter-attacking against the Scots.
Well, it was certainly into his breadbasket there. No excuses for Gregor not holding on to that ball. He'd be very disappointed.
Out on that right wing. I think Tim Horan there thinking that the tackle was a bit high. Matt Burke in concert. 12 metres inside the Australian half. And the scrummage in the front row is having a hard task. That's a pick up by Peters. Armstrong, Yes, it's just a bit slow. They need, Scots need ball quicker than that. It's Chalmers, gets inside to Logan. Good to see the Scots bringing their wings into play. Chalmers once again, fed out very nicely, and it's Ericsson going. Ericsson over halfway, beautifully tackled there by Pat Howard. Up there goes Rowan Shepherd, the fullback. And the physique and power of the Australians being shown there as well, when they manage not only to get ball, but to get a little forward drive going, even in difficult circumstances. And there, the ball beautifully out to David Knox and cleared.
Well, some rousing play there from the Scottish team. Backs and forwards linking once again. Lovely pass from Townsend through to Ronnie Ericsson. A bit of gap, but what a wonderful tackle there from the Australian cover defence. Rowan Shepherd following through, just trying to get there. And who was that back there? None other than Tim Horan. Tremendous. See how quick he gets back on the feet and feeds it to his other winger, Joe Roth.
And once again, the Australian forwards, John Eales, having got the ball there from Richard Harry. Now Payne on to Manu. Another lovely ball to Payne to Knox. They missed out Howard, and it went to Roth. Roth, a lovely run this with the fullback Matt Burke. A great tackle by Rowan Shepherd. One fullback on another, and he held on a bit too long. You must release it immediately, but another brilliant Australian move.
Well, once again, here we see Matt Burke, and Rowan Shepherd did extremely well, because it looked as though Kenny Logan might have come inside, but a tremendous tackle there from Rowan Shepherd, and once again, it just shows, I think, the dangers that this Australian back division can pose.
Chalmers clears way up deep into Australian territory. With 7 minutes to go to half-time, it's 16-6 for Australia. ...48 caps for Craig Chalmers. Patrick Thomas has kept a strict hand on the tiller, as it were. Yes, John Eales got through. Actually went up with the outside arm, and the other one wasn't above head height, so... But nonetheless, Payne's kick charged down. Murray Wallace still. And great to see Murray Wallace getting into the action, a great thrill for him, his first cap.
Well, there again, Murray Wallace, he had a storming game for the Scotland A side at Netherdale and Gala Shields a week last Wednesday, and he'll be very happy with that, and so will members of his family.
Yes, and a great game it was for Scotland A against the Wallabies. There, John Eales helps with the drive and the catch, and the Australians have gained something like 6 or 7 metres round on the wrong side against the Scots. So there on the left, Eric Peters, who got his first cap for Scotland against Canada when he was playing in the Bath second 15, but here he is, he's got 16 now. Knox, a big one. You feel, Gavin, that really Scotland should have had more points on the board, considering those bits of pressure they've had.
Well, that's right. There's been an awful lot of chances with open space, and perhaps they could have done better. But once again, the Australian defence has been very, very good.
Eales at the back took it. Manu powered on another 10 metres. Payne feeds on. That's Richard Harry, the loose head brought forward. And now it's out to the backs. Payne to Knox. And players appearing all over the place. That was Matt Burke again, but Kenny Logan almost got a foot to it, just outside Scotland's 22. And Kenny Logan there, his 25th international. Remember, he got his first cap as a fullback against the Australians when Scotland toured there in 92. She's just outside Scotland's 22. Payne shields the ball. Knox, Howard back to Knox, and another drive in by Horan. That was lovely handling. They've got another lovely ball from the breakdown point. It could have been quicker though. Once more, this is Pat Howard onto John Eales. The orange jerseys really are supporting so well. It's Payne once again. No, 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 she's the referee.
Well, again, here we see the Sterling. Lovely inside pass there and change of angles and direction from Pat Howard. Beautiful flick-up pass. And John Neal, he's having an outstanding game this afternoon, John Neal's.
Scott Shell inside their own 22. Another nice ball for the Australians. Blades got his nose in there first of all. Now it's out to Knox. Howard on the switch. Just a half-missed tackle. And those Australians are in full flow now. They feel that they've got pressure going. It's Knox once again. And Buck the fullback in the line. And there are Australians appearing in positions all over the place where you wouldn't expect them to.
Well, Scotland getting the run around from Australia here. They're really moving the ball well. Lots of options, lots of people running at different angles. But Craig Chalmers and Murray Wallace falling that one. And Scotland really having to stick to their guns to keep the Australians out with about 3 minutes of the first half still to go.
And the salt iron there being waved in acknowledgement of the fact that Scotland are struggling here. Gary Armstrong's put in. Armstrong waits, he's protected the ball. Well, it's a good clearance and there's a bit of relief. Craig Chalmers, who's played a much more rounded game, I think, this season. He's mixed things up very well. Well, that tells most of it. Territory for the Australians. Not as much possession as you would have thought, but they're 16-6 up. Loud blast there. For obstruction pulling down. And John Ewells was just after the ball and it'd been given 10 metres further forward. And not surprisingly, John Ewells goes for the kick at goal.
Well, Scotland not helping the cause here by some lack of discipline. Here we see Donny. We are really trying to get above John Eales there, and I think it was spotted by the referee. And then conceding another 10 yards are really not helping the cause here.
There was, however, clear compression there on the Scottish line with Warwick Waugh lending his 19 stones, or near 19 stones, to shunting a couple of Scottish forwards out of the way. But it has proved effective. Matt Burke here with a chance of knocking over a fifth goal. Matt Burke as well, who played for Australia in the World Sevens in 93, is that kind of gifted player. Awkward side for him though. East Stand will get the best glimpse of this one. Burke then. Oh, and it's straight again. He really is kicking so well. He does this so often for Australia. Four penalty goals and a conversion. It's 19 points to 6. And they're almost up to half-time. And that is some cushion and a tremendous encouragement to the Australians to, well, maybe take an odd risk or two. Craig Chalmers, I don't think, is satisfied with the ball. Pressure of 9.5 to 10 pounds per square inch, it says in the laws. Maybe felt a bit soft to him. It's another hanging restart, but Eales gets up and knocks it back, and that was brilliant stuff again from Payne to Knox. And there the Scots having to trundle back very quickly towards their own 22 as Rowan Shepherd goes there. The chip kick through was a good one. Taken by Foley and fed on. That was David Wilson. Pick up and drive by Warwick Waugh. 10 metres short of Scotland's 22. Lovely ball. They're out to Knox from Payne. Finnegan smashing on further. Payne once again. Pat Howard. Little jinky player. He's
He's like a fish in a burn, him. John Eales goes. And the Australians dominating the possession here. That's about the third or fourth bit of third or fourth phase they've had. Harry goes, and then Foley, the hooker, has another go. Notice how they keep changing the angle. Now there's a chance to move it out as the Scot feed it on very well indeed to Erickson. Erickson inside to Townsend. Townsend, the interception almost by Pat Howard. Down there goes Kevin McKenzie. Cronin feeds Armstrong. Erickson once again. Armstrong had looped him. Fed out from Cronin. Townsend trying to use that pace. Kenny Logan in there as well. And Tony Stanger was over on that side as well. Referee's whistle goes for half time. And the Australians arrive there with a handsome lead of 19 points to 6, having scored just the one try by Warwick Waugh. And there's the magnificent scene here with over 67,000 folk enjoying an exciting game with a lot of movement. And so it's Matt Burke who switches to the other side to start the second half, and John Eales was up very quickly indeed. Down goes Ian Smith, the little fella from Gloucester, the Tiger at flank forward. Scotland 22, Barry Stewart doing a little bit of thumping into Australians, and Craig Chalmers clears wide, and the referee decided it wasn't a big enough advantage. He'd seen, I think it was a bit of obstruction he motioned, and Craig Chalmers will get a second lick at it. The referee Patrick Toma there told me that he wasn't fluent in English, but he had enough to get by. It certainly is just enough. But he's keeping very good control indeed, and Chalmers has responded with that lovely kick. And just checking with the midfield, with Gregor Townsend, the signal has gone along with the Scottish back division, what they're going to do there gives you an impression of where Australia have had a big advantage in the first half. However, Doddy Weir, but it was stolen. David Wilson going through very quickly. Once again, it's Payne. David Knox feeding on, and the ball taken back inside to the forwards. The Australians know where their vast strength lies, and again going down and staying down, which is even worse. Of course, the tackled player and the tackler are both the same now. They've both got to release, roll away, get to their feet immediately. So Knox, big left foot. And that's up close to Scotland's 22. David Knox there, toured in the UK in 1988 with the Australians, and scored something like 54 points on that tour. The very experienced fella, Michael Foley, the hooker in his ninth international, understudied Phil Cairns, that tremendous Australian hooker who got 49 caps. Payne once again, Manu, again goes into the haven of the forwards. Good tackle by Doddy Weir that time. Now they've worked the ball back, but they've been penalised, and that's Andrew Blades, the new cap. Razor they call him, I needn't tell you.
Well, here we see Daniel Manu taking the ball into contact, and Doddy Weir trying gamely, the ball being held out there to Foley, I think the hooker, and all the Australians coming back, but just taking men out that really aren't involved with the play, and that's why he was penalised.
10 metres outside the Australian 22, Doddy Weir just beaten to it by John Eales with his right hand. And here's the roly-poly coming again. Scots are trying to drive in. Of course, the difficulty is that you can't drive in from the side now, and Richard Harry has burst away. Loose head prop in the van of that one, almost up to the 10 metres line. Dutch flag is up, And it's about now that the sheer bulk of those Australian forwards will begin to tell. And Richard Harry is in fact the injured player, the 28-year-old who plays for the Sydney University Club. With his first cap against Wales in 96. Well, this is 96. His first two matches were won by Australia 56-25 and 42-3.
Well, once again, the Australians very adept at this rolling ball. Richard Harry coming straight through the middle, going down the blind side. Great tackle from Gary Armstrong, just clinging on there. And I think maybe Richard Harry might have gone over on his ankle.
So Richard Harry, who's done tremendously well, but Gary Armstrong doing a copybook tackle round the hips and then sliding down and locking the legs. Great jump by Cronin. Armstrong, Chalmers to Eriksson. Armstrong once again. Chalmers. Townsend back inside to Armstrong. Armstrong handing off Australians all over the place. What a tremendously aggressive little fellow he is.
Well, really, for the first time in the half here, we've seen Scotland getting some good, clean, quick ruck line-out ball, and where movement comes in pace, and the rest of the Scotland team, here we see it from the reverse angle. Gregor Townsend taking on a prop. He would have hoped to have beaten Richard Harry, I think, but look at Gary Armstrong handing off Richard Michael Foley, and they off up the touchline.
The Australian 22, and the herd of bisons at work again. And again, look, the ball cleverly moved backwards so that there is a block in front, and so difficult to know where the ball is, where the next thrust is coming from. But they didn't get the ball back, they didn't recycle it. But that was a very effective rolling ball, and there the advantage to the Australians in recycled possession. That's ball from breakdown point. The French referee is really enjoying it. No, he's just and he is trying very hard to explain what he wants and what he's doing. Armstrong, Chalmers, Townsend, typical run of his. Tony Stanger almost up to the 22. The Scots beginning to put bits and pieces together. Gary Armstrong once again. Armstrong. Kevin McKenzie with the thrust. The 22 still. Armstrong. The switch to Chalmers. Kick through. Townsend up quickly. The mark given. And a bit of quick thinking there by David Knox, but a nice quick bit of work there by Gregor Townsend, who has got over his early uncertainty. So Scotland with the penalty and getting a kick at goal. Let's see why.
Again, here we see Bill Scotland looking dangerous when they get some quicker possession, and I think Gregor possibly could have kept the ball in the hand then. Obviously they were lucky that the referee came back and gave Scotland the opportunity to get another 3 points on the board.
Deciding that Gregor Townsend was impeded. And it's Rowan Shipper. Listen to the roar for this one. Oh, he really, he's got it over, but it was an inebriated goal kick, and I'm sure he'll feel lucky about that one. 19-9 though, and they played about 8 minutes of the second half. Matt Burt to restart.
That was tough, wasn't it?
Gary Armstrong once again. It hasn't gone far enough forward, but it will certainly do from the Scottish point of view. Tony Stanger going in there as Joe Roth plays football with it. And it's still in play. And so the Scots caught a little bit unawares there when that ball went loose. And Roth got his foot to it. And so they're inside their own 22 again. Number three there, Andrew Blades. John Eales behind him. Then Owen Finnegan. Some big men at the back there, but it just knocked on, and the Australians have a scrummage. Now then, they've got all the weight that they need. Their front row has looked pretty solid. But you can see they've about, 12, 15 metres to go to the line. There's the hold-in. No extra man can go into the scrum, of course. There can only be eight men. Loud blast. And it's a penalty against the Scots. You can hear the reaction of the crowd to that. I think the Scots may have got themselves into the wrong part of the forward movement. We'll have a look here.
Well, look at the control here. The ball with number eight, Daniel Manu, and they're just tremendous control. The front row of Australia just keeping it as straight as possible. Look at the Scottish scrum just disintegrating. And the ball is picked up there by number seven, David Wilson. And the Scots transgressing, really under an awful lot of pressure there in the scrum ball.
The result of that is Matt Burke on the 22. Notice again how meticulous he is in his preparation. He wants it exactly right. Goes absolutely at right angles to the ball, which is a bit unusual. And there from behind the post, down at the south stand there, we'll get a good view of this one. Matt Burke then. But the flag stayed down this time. He's pulled it past the left hand upright. 19 points to 9, 11 minutes of the second half played. Rowan Shepherd thinking of taking a kick himself, but he goes to Chalmers. Has he put it too far? Well, it's a pretty useful one. Gary Armstrong goes down. Another good kick from Craig Chalmers. He certainly does take charge. He looks so comparatively cool. Notice him shouting out the signals, calling, giving advice here and there. Craig Chalmers, of course, who's captained Scotland on tour. That was against the South Island in the Bay of Plenty in the recent tour of New Zealand. Captained the South of Scotland 10 times. Now they've got Finnegan, yes, Finnegan in the middle there, and he managed to get his jump across the line of throw, line of touch. Waugh was working it back initially. Then it's Harry again, this great, powerful prop forward of 18 stone 5 he is, and that's some weight to take on the hoof as he does. Quite good acceleration for a prop forward too. And so that's the second bullocking run by Richard Harry. There he is, number one, getting up. Used to be a flank forward and changed to prop in 93, and he certainly showed a bit of flank forward pace there. Payne waits, Manu holds. First to decide whether he took it back in, but Manu caught up the side. But Payne, nice ball, Eales going further. Almost up to the 22. Scots, however, have won it. Buddy Weir thrusting on. Australians going in from the side there, but the referee was on the other side. Gary Armstrong. Chalmers has found space over the top of Joe Roth. Roth half caught and gets away from the Townsend. Roth still. This big man who is so manoeuvrable for a fellow of, what, 6 feet two, 6 feet three. Payne has got another lovely ball. Rowan Shepherd, after Daniel Herbert had taken it forward. And Rowan Shepherd bounced it nicely into touch. And really, Gavin, he's had a pretty game.
Yes, indeed. Not an awful lot of Rowan really, unfortunately, seen in attacking positions, and more of his play today and defensive opportunities. But nonetheless, I think Scotland really playing second fiddle to Australia just at this stage. They're hanging off, and if they don't make the crucial tackles, then unfortunately, they're not going to win this game.
Michael Foley, what it was, number two again, but it went to the back to John Eales, and another beautifully timed jump, and once more the surge through the middle. There's no doubt the weight and power of the Australian forwards beginning to tell, and the Scots penalised for going down. Of course, it's a problem for players to decide just what the referee will permit in the way of illegality, and so players at international level tend to try out the ref. Knocks again up to 12 metres inside Scotland's half. So David Knocks there, who can deputise at fullback. He's a highly versatile player. Australia winning it once again. Manu standing off that time, got it from Payne and drove. Now it's out once again, the forwards once more. Finnegan thumping a bit further forward. Now it's Payne once again, but this time to the backs. Knocks half through, inside to Manu. And the Scots trying to recycle it. Warwick Waugh has gone in there, and I think he got hands over it. But it's a penalty again for the Scots, preventing fair release. It's often the case, Gavin, isn't it, that the lighter pack have to offend more in order to try and get the ball.
It so often seems to be that Scotland are the offenders today, and I think this lack of discipline, it's not helping their cause, quite honestly. But you're absolutely right in what you say. The Australian front five really dominating the possession. I mean, we've seen Richard Harry being very, very mobile and loose. He's having an outstanding game. I think John Eales and Warwick Waugh really dominating the lineouts for Australia. And when you've got so much possession, it's very, very frustrating for the opposition. And quite clearly, the Scottish pack are trying everything to get some ball. And unfortunately, the referee has spotted the odd transgression, which is not helping their cause.
And of course, almost up to the last quarter of the match, and that's when the weight of the Australian forwards will tell most of all, perhaps.
That's right. I mean, they're 10 points ahead now, and you know, in all the other games so far in tour, the Scottish teams have been well in the game, and possibly bet more in the game than they are just now. So it'll be interesting to see what happens in this last quarter.
Matt Burke then, and again some old man of whistling as he puts in a high kick and a straight kick once more, and so he's having a great day. That's his fifth penalty goal and a conversion as well. It's 22 points to 9. Craig Chalmers again. John Eales went up for it, but so did Eric Peters. Scots forward standing off in dozens, but it goes straight back to Knox. And Knox once again responsible for pushing Scotland back, taken by Rowan Shepherd. Tony Stanger has it outside again to Rowan Shepherd. He's caught by, well, it was almost caught by Eales. Ian Smith was in there first again for the Scots. He's a little beaver, the flank forward, so often on first there in a support role. The Scots made a great drive there. That really was taken out of the Australian manual. And now Chalmers misses out everybody to Townsend. Townsend to... And taken on once more up to within 10 metres of the Australian 22. And it's here that the Scots must win it again if they want to progress. And they've done through Chalmers. That's a very nice little kick by him. But Matt Burke is back there. And good and strong off his left foot as well. And way back there goes Kenny Logan. And, well, Howard was up, first of all, in the tackle, and of course the fullback as well, Daniel Herbert in too. Scott's ball from this one just a little bit slow. You notice the defence very well positioned. This is Eriksson. David Knox has worked it. The Scots again toiling backwards. Across comes Chalmers. Knox trying to keep it in play. And Ian Smith once again, the first Scottish forward there.
Well, there's a lot of guys, Bill, dead in their feet out there. That was quite a continuity of play there. And Scotland can really thank Gary Armstrong a lot. But Kenny Logan lost the ball in the tackle situation, and Gary Armstrong put his life, if you like, on the line to win that ball and retrieve the ball for Scotland.
Cronin takes it well. Kevin McKenzie goes further. Armstrong. Chalmers. It could have been a charge down by Owen Finnegan if Chalmers had gone through with the kick. However, that was the captain himself who put that one away. So the French touch judge had his flag up. That's Roger Duho, who's from the Basque country, and he obviously has seen a bit of foul play. And it's yes, Richard Harry who's coming forward. So he used a knee, says the referee. And so he went into a player with his knee, and that's dangerous. And so Richard Harry, one presumes that was a formal caution. So you'll have to be careful. Because if he gets a second one, that would mean off the field. So they're into the last quarter of the match. It's 22 points to 9. Scotland shot in the line. Armstrong, Chalmers, missed out Ericsson. Townsend, all good there from Morgan. Beautifully out there to Tony Stanger. On there to Ericsson. Ericsson tackled by Manu. Australian 10 metres line out once again to Chalmers. And you would see the weight of tackle going in there, but the Scots still battling. Goody Weir, one of the first there, and the Australians interfering on the ground. Taken quickly by Cronin, out to Chalmers. This is Shepherd. Shepherd caught by Knox. Daniel Herbert in on a tackle as well. Referee deciding that there wasn't a fair enough advantage. It's still the Scots through Gary Armstrong, on to Kevin McKenzie. Beautifully back again from Armstrong. Chalmers, great bust by Townsend, on to Ericsson. This is great play by the Scots. Ian Smith was in there as well. And it's Townsend once more, and it's a great chance for Logan. Logan with a try. That was brilliant handling. The Scots certainly deserved that try because they moved the ball almost like Australians. Kenny Logan, the try scorer.
Fantastic try here from Scotland. Wonderful support play from Ian Smith. Look at all the forwards coming in, clearing the ball. Quick ball back from Gary Armstrong there. Fed it out to Gregor Townsend once again. Beautiful long-flighted pass. Going to hand this time, and Logan's over in the corner.
If you watch this pass here from Gregor Townsend, Rowan Shepherd was in the line, but with great vision, Townsend missed him out completely, and Logan was home.
Once again from another angle, Gregor Townsend just showing the vision there. A nice floated pass, well taken from Kenny Logan and plucked out the air, and he's over for a try. He'll be relieved to get that one. First time he's touched the ball, I think, today.
His fifth try in Cup Internationals for Scotland. It's 22-14. And Rowan Shepherd with a chance to... the Australians feel maybe a bit anxious. Well, he's hooked it. I'm surprised that he goes in at such a tight angle. That's the third one he's actually sclaffed.
And once again from another angle, we'll just see it. A great attacking here from Scotland. The first time in the match that they've had, again, quick possession, really taking the game for them with the quick penalty. And the Scotland deserve an awful lot of credit, I think, Bill, for running that penalty in what was a good kicking position for them.
So there could be an Australian replacement coming on. But meanwhile, Kenny Logan having another go from the kickoff, taken by Ericsson. Scottish 10 metres line. Armstrong once again to Chalmers. Townsend, and the ball once again to Shepherd. Shepherd feeding back inside to Cronin.
almost up to halfway. The Scots have had their spirits lifted by that splendid try. Armstrong caught by the hooker Foley. And so here once again the Australians counter-attacking, as they do so well whenever the opposition lose possession. Sam Payne to get in first. Howard there. Pat Howard doing the scrum half job. Just keeping it close to the forwards. But the Australians penalised. Again, it may have been for going down over the top of the ball carrier. And this is Brett Robinson, who's looks at it, and it's going to be a substitution because they're bringing off Owen Finnegan, and you'll notice the cards up. So this is the first substitution being made in the Northern Hemisphere rugby since the new law was brought in just this week. Owen Finnegan goes off, and on comes Brett Robinson for his second cap. He'd already got one against Italy when he replaced Bryle. So Brett Robinson, who's another big lad, 6'1", Australian Capital Territories player in the Super 12, and he'll be thrilled, a second cap for him. So there's a bit of history, and there's another bit maybe in the making, a possible sixth Australian victory in a row. 22-14 the lead. Robinson right away gets a feel of the ball, and that's great for a forward coming onto the field cold, as it were. Payne waits, so does Knox. And Knox, yes, good safe touch. But we could be in for a very exciting last 15 minutes. There's only 8 points in it, and the Scots certainly have taken great heart. It's a question now of whether the forwards can keep up the pace despite the fact that they've been giving away so much weight. Again, Warwick Waugh at number two for Australia, but it was Cronin again. He really has jumped well at number two, Damien Cronin. 33 years old now, but a great experienced warrior he is. Kevin McKenzie there, shunted backwards. And Australia will get the put in. Kevin McKenzie, who's short actually of match practice, but went very well against the Harlequins for the Caledonian Reds on Saturday. And here he is, Kevin McKenzie, getting his 11th cap. Manu holds it in. Now the pick-up by Manu, and Peters attacks him immediately, so does Ian Smith. That was very good fringe defence by Scotland. They didn't allow the Australians to get over the game line at all. They can once again quickly. This is Townsend. Townsend looking for the support he got, as I remember it, in Paris from Gavin Hastings just in 95 there when he flipped it. And when the great man ran, well, a long, long way for a super try. But no recipient there. From Chalmers once again. This is Townsend coming in, trying to use his blistering pace as much as possible, but it was knocked on. Gregor Townsend, who has of course that flaring acceleratory pace that is so vital in the cluttered confines of back play nowadays. Payne. Oh, lovely switch to Howard, and Manu came in there at great pace. This is lovely stuff going to Horan. Horan inside the 22. The tackle by Shepherd, brilliantly done. Now it's Payne once again, and the standoff is in the line, and there's a great chance here, and it's Daniel Herbert who goes in. And that was another bit of magnificent vision by the Australians. Daniel Herbert's fourth try for Australia in test matches, and that really is a killer blow to the Scots.
Well, the Australians really showing their class here, and wonderful awareness of where everyone is. A huge long pass there from David Knott out to Daniel Herbert. Tony Stanger, in my book, did right to stay out and rob, hoping that the cover would be there, but an easy try from Daniel Herbert. Wonderful play leading up to this by the Australians. They look so comfortable on the ball. A wonderful distribution, wonderful angles of running, and very, very comfortable. Everyone aware of what the other person is doing.
There's the other angle of it. And watch the dummy here, Daniel Herbert. It was a clear 2-1. Tony Stanger might be criticised for not having a go at the ball carrier so close to the line, but the dummy was a beauty. And of course, as I mentioned, the Australians refer to David Knox as having beautiful soft hands, and on that occasion, rather than the little pop-up pass, it was the huge spinning pass that missed out two players. 27 points to 14. Matt Burke, 17 points so far. Is this another couple? It is indeed. So he's doing the job for Australia that he's done virtually since his first cap as a replacement against South Africa in 93. It's 29-14, 11 minutes of the match left. 6 minutes left, and there the Australians with a handsome victory in the lineouts one. Chalmers out to Ericsson. Ericsson with a good fall. Scots went down over it, but they're getting away with it as Cronin feeds to Chalmers. Shepherd in the line, Tony Stanger going. And Scots really taking it too. They've lasted the pace really well. It's that new scrum half, Damien Cronin once again, but in fact, this is Townsend on once again to Ian Smith. Now it's Ericsson. They're almost up to the 22. This is a remarkable effort by the Scots. Hilton goes plundering round the edge of it. Then Doddy Weir feeds it back. It's Chalmers who gives it out once again. Townsend. And Kenny Logan was over there, having come from the left wing. But may have been knocked forward. And so another stoppage for an injury. It's Craig Chalmers there who's got a knock. And out there comes Dr. Jimmy Graham, who's been honorary medical advisor to the SLU for 9 years. And Gary Armstrong, of course, is hurt. Even worse, and Brian Redpath is ready to come on, and you could hardly have a more useful replacement in that Brian Redpath will come on for his 20th cap. Good, just as an 18-year-old for Melrose, first of all. It was against Glasgow Academicals in 89. And there you'll see Rob Dixon of Madras FP, who's the spare referee as the Australians get ready to celebrate. And Rob Dixon there, he's responsible down there for letting the referee know that the replacement is coming on, and for checking the replacement studs and for his equipment. They've got to be sure that the studs are fair. And so Brian Redpath is on to resume his club partnership with Craig Chalmers, and he'll have taken on a little bit of instruction, I'm sure, from Richie Dixon as well. They've only got about 4 minutes of actual playing time left, and here Gary Armstrong going off with what seems like a rib injury, maybe rib cartilage. And a tremendous ovation for Gary Armstrong as he comes off the field. He's given such a brave performance in difficult circumstances. Meanwhile, it's Payne to Knox, and another lovely bit of work by Knox. And Burke in the line again. Those Australians miss out with passes. They come in at different places. There you see it, Howard going on, giving the pass there. And offside, not retiring quickly enough. And David Knox is just going to thump it up towards the corner flag. And he couldn't have done that much better. So every now and then the Australian backs produce a lightning bit of wizardry, with the ball whizzing about and with loops and dummy loops and scissors at breathtaking pace. Referee says that the throw-in wasn't straight. John Eales is still having a little bit of trouble with that injury. They really bulleted in there, and David Hilton on this side of the front row for the Scots. He's played in two Pilkington Cup finals for Bath. David Hilton is 17th international, and having real trouble there from Andrew Blades, the new cap in the Australian side. This is Chalmers, and that again is over the top of Joe Roth, and it's beautifully hit. Now you'll notice Joe Roth was quite prepared to go away back there in order to take a quick throw-in, which would have been all right. That's Joe Roth, this big 6 feet two and a half wing, and another versatile player who's in his 11th international, and has scored 38 points for Australia in those seven matches. So a goal kicker as well. Foley's throw, huge jump there by Warwick Waugh. In goes Foley. Now they rumble it round to the left. You notice how they change the angle. Payne, Knox, Howard. The pass was just a little bit behind Joe Roth there. Otherwise, it was going to be another cracking move. However, Horan comes across. And there's some lovely work out to Payne, the scrum half. Very good tackle indeed by Brian Redpath. So Scotland get the boot in. 29 points to 14, and we're almost into injury time at the end of the match. The floodlights blazing down here. They're just inside Scottish territory. And I must say that the Scottish forwards have lasted the pace remarkably well, and especially that front row, because they have to take the brunt of it. Kevin McKenzie still striking well. Chalmers into Kenny Logan. If Logan had been able to link up with the support there, there might have been a wide break. Eric Peters trying to drive through, but the whistle had gone, and Australia will get the put in. Very good tackle indeed again by Pat Howard. The Australians having won the last five matches against Scotland, although only on three occasions out of nine here at Murrayfield, but this now looks very much as if it will be the fourth. There's this massive boiler house that the Australians have. Warwick Waugh almost 19 stones, John Eales 17-12. It's some engine room as Chalmers guns out to Townsend. Townsend just hand-tapped and no more. Damien Cronin picks and goes, runs into John Eales and Waugh once again. Ryan Redpath, and it's a lovely pass inside. In fact, if that had gone to hand, well, you can see the goal line. Still the drive, Hilton taking his part. The crowd on their feet here as it goes out to Chalmers. Missing out everybody, the chip kick through, the fullback is in the line. Tony Stanger is there, but he may have hit the flag first of all, but the referee has given the try, and Tony Stanger is the scorer, and that's his 20th try for Scotland in 40 international matches, and it was a wonderful move.
Well, here's a bit of consolation for Scotland in the death here of this match, and a nice little chip there from Gregor Townsend. Look at the way the ball bounces towards the Scottish the Australian line, and it was very close, but touch judge was right there. Here we see it from another angle. Chalmers out to Townsend. It sort of got there eventually, and a nice little chip through. Once again, the ball bouncing towards the Australian line, gathered up by Tony Stanger, and well, the referee gave the try, Bill.
I have to say, I'm a Hoyt man, and Tony Stanger's an ex-pupil of mine, but I just feel that his foot was over the line, first of all. But the referee is the sole judge of fact. He's given the try. His whistle goes for the end of the match, and the Australians have won by 29 points to 19.
But what a splendid finish by the Scots. They were up against it for much of the game, but they've battled spiritedly throughout the whole match. And in a sense, Gavin, the Scottish forwards take a lot of the honour.
Yes, indeed. And, you know, really, the Australians, I think, have shown their composure in this. I really feel that they've played the best game of their two so far. They've really come up to test match level, and unfortunately the Scottish team today just did not manage that. The Australians well worth the victory by 10 points, 29 points to 19, and really they did raise their game today, and you know, unfortunately this large Scottish crowd were fairly subdued for most of the game. Disappointment again for Scotland in their international matches prior to Christmas, and one only hopes that they can go on and perform in the Five Nations like they've done the last couple of years.
And there's a very happy man indeed, Tony Stanger, who of course lies second in the list of top try scorers for Scotland. Of course, the great Ian Smith, the Flying Scot, has 24 tries, but that's Tony Stanger with his 20th. And Warwick Waugh there showing the signs of battle as they go off the field. And as you suggested, Gavin, the Scottish forwards really battled away well, but it was the Australians who made the drives and who took people out better. And there, as you can see, Scotland having scored 2-2, and that is a kind of feather in the cap against this Australian side who'd scored 25 points in the 5 matches leading up to this game. They have that kind of try-scoring potential. So it says something for the Scottish defence that they were able to limit them to 2 tries, but it took some heroic defence to do it.